Welcome back, anyone tuning in. If you want to find out what's in this box, stick around and let's find out. Hobbywing Ezrun. It's the Ezrun Max10 SCT 120 amp and it's a 3660 3200 kV motor. So I'm going to crack these boxes open and we'll see what you get in. This tiny little manual is ridiculous. So it starts off life like this and transforms into this monster here. Let's see what's in the boxes though. That manual's a beast. Let's see what's in them. Let's rip them all apart. Let's tear the motor out first and we'll get this out. Oh, the entire thing slides out. Nice. Just put that there for a second. So, manual. That'll obviously tell you the basics of the motor. You get a pinion in there. I don't know what pitch it is. But it does say on the back there, 25. So that's got 25 teeth on it, and I guess we'll find out what pitch is at the end of the video if I can find that out. So I'm gonna slide this out. Nice. That does feel like a proper bit of quality in your hand. Like, never mind these cheap little brushless setups that you get off eBay, you know what I mean? That is absolute quality. Outstanding. So yeah, 3660, sensorless, 3200 kV. That there on the back is a temperature gauge. It's got a temperature thing on the ESC there, so obviously that'll plug into the motor just in the back there, and you can set that. It's got it all in the manual. It tells you everything, how to set the ESC. But yeah, we're just going to take a quick look at everything, guys, and see what it's like. It does look absolutely fantastic. Mate, that's enough drooling of that. Anyways, let's move on to the ESC box. There we are, slidey box. These box, the packaging's absolutely fantastic as well. It sounds stupid, but you're paying for the packaging, so you might as well have a feel, have a look, admire how the quality of it and all the rest of it, you know what I mean? Sounds nuts, but yeah, I do that. Let's rip the entire box out. And then, because that looks like it's going to be fiddly with my thumb, so I'll get back to you once I've got this out. 120 amps in all its glory. Power button and set button, all in one. This little lead here, that's actually connected to the other side. That's your heat temperature, so that plugs into the back of the motor. And you can set that, what temperature it'll pick up via your ESC, and it tells you all that in the manual as well. That's plugged into your receiver, obviously. One to steer, two for the rear, so the power supply, this goes into number two on your receiver. It's got 12 gauge wires on, and I'm running XT90s on all my batteries, so that's what I actually got with that anyways. You can get them with different connectors on. So also in the box with the ESC, you get a little bag of goodies here. I'll rip this open and show you what we've got. Right, so the extra that you get in the package, you get an extra little fan there. I guess that's just in case the one that you have on burns out. Put that on one side. You get a mounting plate here for your ESC with the screws. And you also get some M3 double-sided sticky pads, really. So also, you've got this cable here. So that's for your reader cord, for you to fit it in. You unplug the fan on the ESC and that goes into there. So you get a little cap pack like that. And when you look in the manual, it says, if the cap packs on the ESC, so I'll bring the ESC back in here, if the cap packs get over 80 degrees C, you need to fit that little cap pack there on the terminals of the live and the negative, yeah? And they even give you that tiny little bit of heat shrink for you to somehow get over there. So I guess that's obviously when you've fitted it, you just slot that in and heat shrink it round. But yeah, it looks a bit finicky. But that's what it says in the manual. So if it goes over 80 degrees, you want to be fitting that to your live and negative terminals, yeah? And have the heat shrink over it once you've done it. Solder that on, solder it, solder off, who cares? And that'll do. But yeah, guys, that's what I'll be running soon in the Typhon. I just thought I'd have a quick little look at it and give you guys my overview. So yeah, hope you enjoyed that one. And I'll catch you in the next one, guys. So about this pinion that comes with the motor for the Hobbywing system. So up here, this is a mod 8, this is a 32 pitch, this is a 0.7, and that's a 0.6 pitch, and none of those match up with this. So that makes me think this is a 48 pitch. I don't know if any of you guys can tell just by the teeth or anything like that, but They're the opinions I've tried it against, and none of them match up.